Okay, mighty dark inside here. Why is it so dark? All the windows are covered with hurricane stuff. Those are aluminum storm panels. I think 063 aluminum storm panels, and the openings there are sliding glass doors, 8 feet high, 10 feet wide. So that's a big opening. And I know the light level is different. The glass block is very well reinforced. I set that myself. And in the garage, with my airplane in here, there's posts that I put up. This is all pre-hurricane. Well, this is right after Hurricane Andrew, all this stuff was done. This is a 1990 house, and before product-approved garage doors and things like that. So a lot of this stuff is not product-approved. It's just what I did to try and be prepared in the aftermath of Hurricane Andrew. And then we go outside. I still have to rig up a 2x4 to hold the door shut and go outside here. Wind is starting to pick up, and Rebecca is going to move her car, and there's the garage door that is reinforced on the inside. So on the outside, what we have is there's a catwalk system that allows me to put the panels up, the storm panels, and you can see they have the clips. They're the old style, but it's aluminum, corrugated aluminum storm panels. And then I have this geotextile fabric that I was going to use instead of the aluminum storm panels, but for this hurricane, I'm going to use both. So I had the storm panels. This is my first time putting up the fabric, and we'll see how it works. Again, there's the other one. I don't have an anchor for the middle strap there. That would be better if I did, but I didn't have time to do that. Again, there's the same kind of catwalk plank. You can see up there that's resting on the angles and the aluminum corrugated for the clips. Okay, so in order to put all that stuff up, I had a scaffold. I had to use the scaffolding, and I decided I was going to use the scaffolding to protect the air conditioners from falling tree limbs. So there's a dead tree up there, a dead pine tree, that is going to fall. There's lots of different directions it could fall, but it could fall this way. And these are my old post-Hurricane Andrew storm panels that are anchored pretty well, 3/8 inch plywood, but not a very big span, so I think it's okay. Walking around the back here. So more storm panels up above are the roll down shutters, probably the weakest link, is we have the backside, that's one of the bathrooms, and behind that fabric up there is another big roll-down shutter. And here you see how the storm panels work, and they all have this angle that reinforces the storm panel, kind of holds it together to keep it from bowing out. So that's ready. And I got my gas here for the generator. Kind of not too bad. That's, I don't know, 24 gallons, something like that. Put the garbage cans, put in a safe place. They didn't pick up the garbage yesterday, so got some stink. It's going to be some stinky garbage after a while. Again, there's the clip system. Used to anchor bolt into each of the one of the storm panels, but that's really, really hard and time consuming, and I can't do that. So hopefully these are not going to blow off. And again, more plywood. Our storm panels. I took the, it's too bright, but I took the antennas off. I had an antenna there. There's a bat box and a couple antennas, and all of that came down earlier today. This is a tree that fell down in 2005 that I have propped up. There's my mini split glass block on the outside. That's pretty solid. I think it's got joint reinforcing in every course, so I don't think that's going to blow in. And there's a mini split that's very well anchored to the wall with my anchors, not the ones that came with it. So that's in very solid. Hopefully that'll survive. I may live in the garage afterwards if anything happens. So that's the quick tour.